deep in my eyes, they know it's real. Yeah, been this way, way before the deal. Say this one for your photo real. Blessing after testing, I'ma show them skills. You ain't gotta tell me, I know I'm ill. Stars treacherous, I effortlessly show them skills. Yeah, so suspenseful, I'm up in the field. Saw it in my eyes, it was the Tiger Hill. Gonna jump off the line and see the flight of field. Rewrite your history, I'm this line right here. Your best bet be ahead, easy to get rich or dead. Try, this ain't nothing new, I just be 10 steps instead. Snooze, I won't, I can't lose, ready, rest or a bed. Do what you can to do, make your next move your best. I do this for the family, I might just blow my wheel. I'm giving it so for real, who feeling that glowing hill? I'm giving they soul the chills, my journey code is chill. Stories treacherous, I effortlessly show them skills. Yeah, off the edge like I don't know no feel. See the pain deep in my eyes, they know it's real. Yeah, been this way, way before the deal. Say this one for your photo real. Blessing after testing, I'ma show them skills. You ain't gotta tell me, I know I'm ill. Stars treacherous, I effortlessly show them skills.
I'm in the rest, I never switch, I see the rest, I get the money back. the switch. They saying you switch, you wonder. You know they came from the bottom and now we is lit. You was lit, I gotta get it, I gotta get it. You hatin' cause I said no risk. My bitch, you wanna be famous, huh? They elevate the maters, huh? You know I'm icy in Vegas. This for the haters, huh? I make a lot of new money, huh? When the d***s not save us, huh? You be liking my flavor, huh? I think it's cause I said no risk. Call the rest, call the rest. Watch out for us.
First opened in 2002, there's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Carolina Panthers and the Detroit Lions. As of this morning, summer officially over. It's time for autumn football, and we're underway on EA Sports. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. A solid run on first down, gain of seven, leaves them with a second and three.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Throwing on second and three. Murray dancing to his left. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. He's tackled at the 29-yard line. It's a gain of a yard. But just play number three here on the opening drive, and it's an early third and one. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. Well, he's going to run into a brick wall right in the middle of the field, and I don't think he got there. Strong start by this defense. Third and short, they go with a run. Stonewalled for no gain.
I played for a guy who always talked about setting tones and meeting force with force. That felt like it on that play, didn't it? And they met it in a big way and won. What a great job by the defense. At their own 17-yard line.
Here we go. Set 94. You're not ready. You're not ready.
Now a carry. It's C.J. Anderson. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 11, he goes down. That really sets him back. A loss of six.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
A big-time run there by Anderson. 66 yards for him on the ground. Nothing fancy there. A little smash-mouth football right up the gut on the dive, and it turns into a huge play.
You talk about the fastest way to the secondary. Right up the gut, as you described, and sprinted into the secondary for a long, long run.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. He'll have a first down inside the 10. And all the way down to the... 5.
19 more yards. That's another Detroit Lions first down. First and goal at the 5-yard line.
They've made goal line offense a priority on the practice field this week. This is exactly the situation they've been prepping for. They'll set up a throw. And this is going to be intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler Luke Kuechly that picks it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. When the rookie QB gets his first touchdown pass, that's one you put in the trophy case. First career interception, that's going to be one he wants to forget.
Yeah, and he's not going to go ask for the football, right? Yeah, you can keep that one. The key for him, what does he learn from it? When he watches the tape, does he have an answer right now where he already understands what mistake he made? That's what the coaches are going to want to know, and that's what they'll grill him on and see how he grows from it.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Anthony Walker, the blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked by Darrell Worley. And a return across midfield and to the 46-yard line. Well, certainly not how he wanted to start his night. First throw of the game, an INT.
Yeah, it's not easy, but he's got to try and wipe that one away from the memory banks. And let's face it, it's not often a quarterback and a defensive back have a lot in common. But one thing, because they have these individual-type plays, they've got to have short memories, don't they? DB gets beat, wipe it away. Quarterback throws a pick, has to do the same thing.
Rip right. Charlie. Let's go. Ready.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. Almost able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on to on this first drive. Instead, second down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been 2 drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. The pass incomplete to Sutton, and he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 15 yards on the play, first down. On first down, he'll drop to throw. No, bottled up. It's out. It's loose.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Third down and 13.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw here. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Brian Burns able to get him down for a loss of 11, and it brings up fourth down. Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first 2 drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now, and I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. They'll run with McCaffrey. Looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. Bud Dupree, a former first-round pick, in on the stop.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Murray with a third and long. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down. Here's Michael Pilardi now, standing just outside his own goal line. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt, and the Lions will take over. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
And things haven't started so well for this side. Two drives, two punts.
So now you've got to start looking not just at play calling, but which guy's going to step forward and say, okay, let's get this thing done. Because within that unit of 11, sometimes one guy can make a big-time play and break through the barrier.
Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. From the pistol, they run with Anderson. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. It's a loss of two, now third down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They wanted it every position, and we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss.
I'm going to come back to you.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's got a man. It's Sutton that's complete. No score after one on EA Sports. Second quarter action now from Detroit, and it's the homestanding Lions who have the football as they've got it with a first and 10.
Right there.
Back to throw now on first down. That one complete to Anderson. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. He'll get a dozen there, and the Lions have a first down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. He'll look to throw. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second down.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
Push him back.
Here's Anderson. He's got it on the draw. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
First and goal at the 9-yard line.
Okay, ready? 56. I got you, son. You're all mine.
They'll run. Anderson. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down. So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. And able to get him inside the 5 here, just inside the 5 to about the 4. 7 big yards on the carry there to get him within range of the goal line with third down upcoming.
Here we go.
They'll come out in the pistol. They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. Here's Anderson. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. C.J. Anderson, his second touchdown on the season, as his guys are on the board first here tonight.
But they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times that's a passing play.
And the kicker, this has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
Vinatieri connecting on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last drive, three and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that three and out on the last possession, that told you just how stalled they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. On second down, McCaffrey. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down. Murray on third down, and it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down. Here's Michael Pilardi now as he's on to punt for Carolina. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Things progressing to plan so far. Their defense has been solid, and they've got themselves a 7-0 lead after the touchdown the last time they had the ball.
And this is no time to even think about, hey, are we going to milk the clock? Hey, are we just going to do ball control? This is the NFL. 7-0 leads, they don't last very long unless you continue to push the envelope on offense.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They run Anderson. Anderson loses the football, and it's picked up by the Panthers. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
Anthony Walker able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Murray now. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. The Panthers on third down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be third and 19. Murray going to throw. He's got this one complete to Sherfield. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. We know that Gano has that big leg. He had the longest made field goal in the NFL last year, 63 yards to beat the Giants in week four. That was the longest game winner in NFL history, and he converts from long here again. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Yeah, last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. He sets to fire deep. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it, and he'll wind up losing 5 yards or so on the return, but no matter, they've got the football back. Second interception for him now here in this first half, and you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question, because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on, his teammates going to check on it, because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. Throw it. Open man is Samuel. Complete. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. Here's Michael Pilardi now. He's been terrific so far. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the 20. At their own 20-yard line. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball down.
Off to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes. Back-to-back, what a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a 2-for-1 without ever even giving up the football. The opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. 10th carry now for Anderson. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now a run with Anderson. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. First down for the Lions on a nice pickup of 18 yards. First down. Here's the run with Anderson. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven.
Man, I got you. Man, he called. 132 fight. Three. Hayward. What happened?
Here's a second and seven. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. The tight end set to valve the intended receiver, and it's third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. They're going to look to throw. Screen play, Anderson. And he is going to lose yardage here. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Here's Britton Colquitt now as he'll punt it away for the second time. .46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. Oh boy, he fielded it right on the goal line. A very good return that time, 18 yards. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. And this time they'll just keep this on the ground. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Lions in the lead, and they're going to get the football first as well as the second half is underway. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace.
C.J. Anderson! Touchdown, Detroit! C.J. Anderson, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Lions are able to extend their lead. He's been having a great game, and that one right there, his best run so far, and it ends with 6 points.
And not only that, in his mind, what is he thinking? Can I get to 200 yards as well? Because he knows he's closing in on it. He may not know the exact number, but the best runners have a feel of what the yardage is that they're compiling, and he knows that he's getting close to that 200-yard mark now.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown. Oh, now Murray has it stripped. And this is scooped up by the Lions. Look at this. Middle of the field. A breakaway. And into the end zone. A scoop and score on the fumble return for the Detroit touchdown. Vinatieri now to tack on the PAT. And it's 21-3. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And let's just say they're going to be looking to start over on this drive. A few moments ago, they were in the exact situation, but their first play led to a fumble that was returned for six.
Yeah, you definitely have to have a short memory to play in the NFL. You got to remember what you did wrong so you don't repeat it. But you can't dwell on it because then you will repeat it. And that's what you don't want to do.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. This is McCaffrey. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
From the 36, Murray, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Steven Weatherly, able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time. These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. To throw, it's Murray. Completes it to Samuel. A big gain of 28 as the drive continues. Now, they've been struggling in the passing game. Do you like the aggressiveness there? I mean, it worked on that play, but do you like it?
I do, because a lot of the time you're struggling because your passing lanes are clogged. That usually happens when you're throwing the ball underneath. People start to press up on you. Push them deep. Find some space and open things up again. Being aggressive there, I think, will pay off for them.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9. On second down, here's Murray. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And it's going to be another first down as he'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 29-yard line.
Well, as this game continues to evolve in the NFL, you know how much coaches love run after catch, but you know what they love even more? Completion.
Yeah, just holding on to the ball.
Catch it. Cover it, tuck it away. Whatever you get after that is almost gravy. That's how a lot of these receivers are being taught now.
11 yards and a Panther first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Took till the second half, but finally a red zone opportunity here. They have a first and 10 at the 18. Flushed out right. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Well, this secondary has done such a good job of frustrating these receivers tonight. Another example right there on the deep ball.
Sometimes when the sun goes down and it's just the bright lights in the stadium, there's a little extra spring in their step, doesn't it? And that's what we're seeing from the defenders. Denmark, the man, the zone. Deep ball, short ball. That was a deep one there. They're making plays on the football, contesting everything.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Here's a second and five now after the offsides penalty. McCaffrey following the penalty. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a third and three.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. It's a gain of six as they're able to convert, and now it's first and goal. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Eluding the touchdown, Carolina.
Well, this was a pass all the way, but he just kept buying time, didn't he? It was kind of like, wait. Oh, it's open. Time to hot foot it and go. And boy, was he successful.
Yeah, didn't go to the outside toward the pylon, just straight ahead, middle third of the field.
Shortest distance between 2 points. Straight line.
Extra point try, good by Gano. And it makes the score 21-10. This is taken about 7 yards deep. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
They run again on first down. Anderson. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and three.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy. At this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three. They run with Anderson. He's been the bell cow tonight. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Let's go, defense. Let's get out the field, defense. 80 weapon.
They'll run it. Here's Anderson. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 44-yard line.
22 Jeff Bomber.
This is Freeman. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
The tackle made back at the 48-yard line.
One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second down now. It's Anderson. Give him 4 on the carry there, but that only takes him back to where they started. 3rd and 10.
That's a gain of 4. Brings up 3rd and 10.
H3, 2, 18. Chopper. Check 59. Mike is 59.
He'll drop to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up 4th down. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play if you're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback because the space doesn't open up. They were able to read that one and slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
Colquitt on to kick as he sends it away. This is fielded at the 7. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and the Panthers will have a 1st and 10 from deep in their own territory. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they had to go the length of the field last time out to get into the end zone. And with this starting field position, they're going to have to pretty much do it again.
And I think the thought process going into it is, hey, if you have to be methodical, go ahead and do that. But what you really want are a couple of big plays. Eat up chunks of yardage and cut down the number of times you have to snap the football.
The Panthers have the first. It's a gain of 12. Murray now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's 1st and 10. Here's Murray. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. They hold him to only 2 there on the screen. It's 2nd down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a 1-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. They'll break the huddle. Come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. Throwing now is Murray. And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. Stephen Weatherly, his 2nd sack of the night.
Remember throughout my career here in defensive coaches, you always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. Well, they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed. He's going to wind up. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. A big play there for Carolina. And even 40 yards. So the big play gets him across midfield now for 1st and 10. So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
They will come up on a 1st and 5 following the encroachment penalty. Out of the gun, here's Murray. sideline throw. That's caught by Moore. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Now, a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield.
So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. Murray looks to throw again, second and 10. Looking for Thomas, but that's intercepted. Picked off at the 14. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games. And now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Now, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Again, Anderson. And he loses the football a second time. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And he'll get this back down to about the 12-yard line.
Partner, that one looked like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, two-score game. So hold on here, not done in the fourth. Following that fumble recovery, it's Murray being chased out left. And he will score! Touchdown, Panthers! Kyler Murray with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year as his guys are back within a single score. So a big play coming for the Panthers. They'll go for two. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Right now clinging to a one-score lead, Charles, and I think operating within that four-minute offense with a little less than 4 minutes to go applies here, right?
It certainly does, and that means the playbook is still wide open. But you are a little bit more careful about what you're calling. You want plays that are going to gain yardage, how would you say it, consistently, right? You don't need the big shots downfield, but make sure the clock continues to run. Pile up the first downs, and the goal? End the game with your quarterback kneeling down at the end, and you still have the lead.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Second and 10. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. And a big turning point here in the second half, Charles, after that play.
All you're trying to do is change momentum, flip things around for your team. You're just trying to take the ball away. How about when you take it away and score? That really changes things.
Here's Murray, and this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. So they make the decision. They want a three-point lead versus a two-point lead, and they got it.
Yeah, at this stage of the game, it seems like the exact right thing to do. Put a little pressure on your defense, but the biggest thing now is you're making the other team chase you.
And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they've got to be still reeling from the events of a moment ago. What a turn on that last play.
You knocked it on the door. You're about to take it in. You think you're going to get some points on the board. Instead, you cough it up and watch them take it the rest of the way to the opposite end zone. That's a two-score swing that you just gave up.
First down. First and 10.
54.
On first down, he'll drop the throw. He's going to air one out. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. They were trying to erase that deficit in one play.
They certainly were, but how about the reaction time and the instincts back deep to force the incompletion? We might need to mark this one down. We may look back and say, that was a game-saving play.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Come on, the ball.
They'll drop the throw. And that's going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. He'll get that to DeVal, the tight end. Three points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on first and 10. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. And avoids the contact by sliding. So a decent game, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty.
This is our team's field. Bravo!
Check, check, 59.
Back to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler Luke Kuechly that picks it. And he'll take it across midfield to the 46-yard line. The tight end set to valve the intended receiver. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think, okay, he's the guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Even though we're not on the goal line, this is essentially a goal line look as they come up for second down. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And oh, he spins past him and into space. A big pickup there, and without question, that should be more than enough to wrap this one up.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
And that one blown up Kuechly. as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. On the ground, McCaffrey. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play. So it doesn't affect the outcome, but a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lagniappe, a little extra on top.
The extra point up and good, but this one was decided anyway, as that will be the final action in this ball game. So we had action to the very end of this one. The score on the final play that they didn't need to have. They didn't just run out the clock, though. They added to their final total.
Played it all the way to the end, and you know, some coaches preach that and tell their teams, that's what I want all the time, and they feel like if they don't do it themselves, they're not living up to the message that they're sending out.
So for Carolina, it's an ideal start as they move to 3-0 now on the young season. And they'll get a few extra days to get ready for next week. Meanwhile, for Detroit, they'll fall to 1-2. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week.